I know. Disappeared real fast.
I went to get another one. It's like, I only had one. Oh well, all good.
Beat on that tom-tom.
Good morning, everybody. If you're in the lobby, please make your way in. We're going to get started. We're going to spend the next 15 to 20 minutes in worship, and what that just means is we're going to sing some songs and try to talk to God and have him talk back to us and just have a little conversation. Could all just stand for the first song? Have that, just let your body reflect what your heart's feeling. Start with prayer. God, we just ask you to come and fill this place. Just come in now. Reveal yourself in a new way.
Let our praise be your welcome. Let our song be a sign. We are here for
Prayer, all that. white 3 inches.
Double A is singing.
Okay, white 3 inches. Shout. Yeah, and then white 2. Leave that thus. But take
3.3 out. Wait. Kind of wait to see. They try to go to the middle one.
There is power in you.
morning. My name is Chris Worrell, and I'm the site pastor here in Auburn, and I'd like to welcome you all this morning. Especially if you're here for the first time, we want to extend a warm welcome to you. We're so glad that you took the time to come and find us and be with us this morning. We have a gift we'd like to give you that looks just like that little gift bag, that maroon gift bag, and it's on the other side of the wall in the lobby. And so make sure you grab one of those. It's got all kinds of information in it and some chocolate candy. You might want to get that. All right. I want to tell you a few things that we have coming up here. First of all, next Sunday, right after the service, we're going to be having a newcomer's pizza. So if you're newer to the Vineyard and you've never went to one of those, it is a free pizza lunch for you and your children. And at that lunch, you can meet the staff, you can find out more about the church, meet other people who are newer. And it takes about 45 minutes, so we'd love to invite you to stay for that after service next week. The next thing I want to let you know about is that we have a safety team, and Norm Reynolds kind of oversees our safety team, and these are the people that go into each, you know, they just walk around the building and make sure that everything is safe for us. The kids are where they belong, and, you know, everything is copacetic, and so we're really grateful to them. So Norm is going to have a meeting with the guys who are already members of the safety team, and for anybody who would like to consider being part of the safety team, that'll be right after this service today, right in the room behind me. And then for many of us who have known Margie Remsnyder for a few years, Margie was our 96-year-old resident, dynamo, fabulous woman. Margie went home to be with Jesus this week, and she was very delighted to go, and we're very happy for her. The services for Margie are down in Virginia. They were yesterday. And so if you're looking for, if you want to send letters of condolence or anything, you just call the office and we will give you Mary, her daughter's address. All right? So let me tell you to do what? To pull out your connection card. Helps to know what you're doing next, right? I think they have a commercial on TV about that.
Have a connection
right?
card.
The guy who's doing the lottery, and they say it helps to know what order things go in. Anyway, I guess you have to see it. In your program, there's a connection card. Looks just like this, and you can pull this out. And I'd like to ask everyone to fill one out. If you're here for the first or second time, just fill out as much as you're comfortable filling out. And you might want to check whether you're here for the first or second time, because we have a gift that we'd like to give you and send in the mail for you. So, and then you can flip it over, and there's all kinds of things that you can fill out on the back. So take a few minutes and get started with that, and we'll get ready up here.
She's going to use the hand on this year.
Okay, so this morning we have from elementary school, Cassandra Quinn. She is graduating from Owasco School. She worked very hard and earned A's and B's this year. Church in multiple locations, we share the same vision and the same leadership and the finances and the same values. And so we are excited to be a part of that and to be introducing it here in Auburn. And so I invite you this morning, we're going to watch a message by our lead pastor, John Elmer, and we're going to engage with the screen. So sit back and enjoy, and I will talk with you afterwards. Thanks.
Today at Cicero and Auburn. Glad you joined us for today's message. You know, the neighbor is an interesting person. I mean, there are all kinds of neighbors. I remember when growing up, we had, you know, the mean, angry neighbor who were all afraid to walk on his grass. When I was in college, down the hall, I had this neighbor who was way too loud, partying way too much. Gwen and I, in L.A., we had this neighbor who was a crackhead, lived right next door. We were always terrified that he would get in, and we were always locking everything. It made us nervous. And this one building I lived in, we would walk down the hall, you know, a couple times a day, you know, going in and out, and the door would always be open a crack because it was so hot they didn't have any fans or electric, you know, air conditioning, but there was always like a dozen people sleeping there. There must have been two dozen Salvadorians living in that place. You know, probably all undocumented workers working hard, just crashing any time of day they could when they weren't working, so they could share this apartment so they could send as much money home to their families. You know, neighbors, all kinds of, the Smiths have been my neighbors for over 20 years. Wonderful people, they're like family now. We're so close and tight. It's awesome having those other neighbors. And yet, living in the same house, there's another neighbor who literally I've had one conversation with in 20 years. I mean, when I first moved in and saw him in the backyard, I went out and said, "Hey, how you doing, John? I just moved in." He turned away and walked away. And I like to make sure he's, I guess, not around when I'm out there. And it was really weird about a year, 2 years ago, I planted a couple of trees in our backyard. And he said, I just want you to know that those trees you planted were actually on my property, because where they put the fence is actually on my property. Jesus had a lot to say about neighbors. So I'm going to